Welcome to another episode of Daily Musings from Sacred Ground. In Buddhism, people often speak of the Noble Eightfold Path, the pathway that leads to non-suffering. And the Vietnamese Buddhist monk Thich Nhat Hanh, he writes of right speech. Now, when he speaks of right speech or right mindfulness, right diligence, right thinking, right view, he encourages us not to think in terms of right versus wrong, but more right as in what's helpful, what's healing, what's beneficial. So we could say beneficial speech or right speech. And Thich Nhat Hanh, they often call him Thay. One of the things that Thay speaks of when he talks of right speech is that it also involves right listening or compassionate listening. Now, when we think of compassionate listening, we might think, okay, well, that means we're listening to understand, right? And certainly that's part of it. But he suggests that there's even a deeper level, that even if we do not understand, we can still listen to reduce the suffering in the other. Because Thay says that when someone is making us suffer or making others suffer, it's because they're so saturated with suffering that it's spilling out, spilling over. And I know I've had occasions, maybe you have too, where you try to share with somebody, maybe a friend or a loved one or a family member, and maybe they don't quite get you or they don't quite get what you're trying to share, but you can tell they're trying, right? And that does usually bring some level of relief. So at the deepest level, we listen to reduce the suffering in the other. Well, that's easily said, not so easily done, right? Because if you're like me, you know, we tend to, when the other person speaks, we want to correct them. We move into judgments about what they're saying. I'm reminded here of the Sermon on the Mount. And Jesus says, we've all heard this, right? Judge not that ye be not judged. For with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye met, it shall be measured to you again. Well, it's really tough to stay out of that judgment of others. And of course, in these challenging times when there's so many chasms between people, and people are seeing reality and understanding the world in such different ways, it's so difficult. But maybe we can do it a little. You know, maybe we can give that friend or family member 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, where we could just sit and really try to listen. To listen with true compassion. And certainly try to understand, but if we don't understand, we could just invite ourselves to think, okay, this person has suffering in them. They're saturated with it. And some of it's just spilling out. But I can listen. And I can try to create the space to hear, not to correct in this moment, not to fix, but just to listen. Compassionate listening. Part of right speech.
I'm Michael Malley, and you've been listening to Daily Musings from Sacred Ground.